of the Holy Quran. May I please call upon stage Maulana Nomani to please inaugurate the ceremony.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر. سبحان الله عما يشركون. آمنت بالله صدق الله وخالقنا العظيم. آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. میرے مالک تلاوت شدہ آیات کا جو ثواب ہے ہمارے پاکستان کے بانی مبانی محمد علی قائد اعظم صاحب اور ان کے علاوہ جتنے حضرات جنہوں نے پاکستان کو بنایا اور قبروں میں چلے گئے اور پاکستان کی سرحدوں کی حفاظت کرتے کرتے افواج کے ساتھ ہی قبروں میں چلے گئے، یا اللہ ان کی روحوں کو اس کا ثواب پہنچا دے. میرے مالک ان کی قبروں کو منور فرما، ان کے درجات کو بلند فرما، پاکستان کو ترقیاں عطا فرما، نظر بس سے محفوظ فرما، اس کینیڈا کی بھی حفاظت فرما. یا الہ العالمین، پاکستان کے ساتھ محبت کرنے والوں کی ترقیاں عطا فرما، دلی تمناؤں کو پورا فرما، بیماروں کو شفا عطا فرما. تمام بہنوں کا، بھائیوں کا یہاں آنا اور جن حضرات نے خصوصی طور پر یہ پروگرام ترتیب دیا ہے پاکستان کی محبت میں، میرے مالک ان کی محنتوں کو قبول فرما. ربنا تقبل منا انک انت السمیع العلیم. سبحان ربک رب العزت عما یصفون وسلام علی المرسلین والحمد للہ رب العالمین. السلام.
For the national anthem of Canada, followed by the national anthem of Pakistan. May I please request the Consul General of Pakistan, Dr. Mohammed Tariq, to come on stage for the flag hoisting ceremony, and Vania Jabran to please come and do the honors.
Enough.
event that marks the 69th Independence Day, the Pakistani-Canadian community decided to organize a Pakistan festival to showcase the cultural heritage, diversity, geography, music, dress, cuisine, customs and traditions from all corners of Pakistan. The importance of this event goes beyond providing a venue for families to meet and have fun. It provides Pakistani Canadians with a voice and platform to promote understanding amongst other communities. It is our hope that through this initiative, Canadians of all regions and origins will gain a better understanding of the people of Pakistan and a greater appreciation for the unique culture. Above all, this event provides an opportunity for strengthening friendships, cooperation between Canadians of Pakistani origin and the greater Canadian community. I'd like to take this opportunity to also thank our distinguished guests, senators and consuls that have joined us on this auspicious day. Consul General of Venezuela, Consul General honoring Cambodia, Consul General of Turkey, Consul General of Mexico, Consul General China, Vice Consul General of Afghanistan, Consul General honoring Ukraine, Consul General of the United States, Consul General honoring Slovenia, Consul General Korea, Consul General Republic of Ecuador, Consul General Indonesia. Thank you all for being here and making this event so special. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pakistan Festival has been a great accomplishment. We all know that putting an event together of this autosy is placed for a successful event, no simple task. The Pakistan Festival is brought to you today in collaboration with the Consul General of Pakistan in Vancouver, in conjunction with Pakistan Canada Association, Pakistani Canadian Women's Society, and the Pakistani Youth Council. I'm truly thankful to everyone who volunteered their time. It's really inspiring to see. CIPC's Pakistan Festival 2016 would not have been possible without the support of our sponsors. Title sponsor, CIPC. Gold sponsor, Maharaja Banquet Hall, Pat National Foods, Diamond Carpet. Silver sponsors, Fuji Homes, Nazis Pharmacy, PCA Edmonton, Pizza 73 Edmonton, Integrated Security System, and all of our bronze sponsors, thank you very much in making this event possible. Last but not the least, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out here today. This celebration of culture through entertainment, food and dialogue marks the 69th Independence Day for Pakistan. I truly hope all of you enjoy yourselves here tonight. I would now like to introduce our title sponsor, CIBC's David Knapp, Business Development Manager, to join us on stage and tell us about their role in this festival and the new product that they are launching. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much and good afternoon, everybody. It is truly our privilege to be here today and to have been invited to contribute to this wonderful festival. I must say, the day, the location, the food, everything is just perfect. With a backdrop like this, I think you'd agree with me that it's going to be tough to beat. I want to echo your comments just now around the hard work that has gone into this festival. I know that it is not possible without a lot of labor. The organizing committees, the volunteers, everybody involved to put all these details together is a huge task. So thank you to all of you. So on behalf of my CIBC colleagues, all the staff across this great country and across British Columbia, we are so thrilled and honored to be a part of this festival and having had the opportunity to contribute to its success. And speaking of my colleagues, I'm here today with a bunch of my colleagues. You'll see us under the CIBC tent there. You may have walked past, or you may have already had a chance to visit with us. But if you haven't had a chance to come visit with us, I encourage you to do so. We have two very exciting things going on at our booth. The first one is that you can enter to win a dream vacation. So I know that I'd be pretty excited about that. So if you like to travel, please come and see us and enter for your chance to win. And the second thing, which is also very exciting, is that just in the last few days, we've launched a new product called Global Money Transfer to Pakistan. So that is a service and a product that makes sending money overseas very, very easy. And you can do it directly from your CIBC bank account. So if you can pay a bill online, you can send money overseas to Pakistan. So we were pretty excited about it. And again, we can tell you all about that at our booth. But that's about enough from me. Thank you very much. That's about enough from me. I know there's lots going on backstage here, so I'm going to make way for the real show. And once again, thank you so much, and have a great festival.
May I please request Haroon Khan, representing the Pakistan-Canada Association, an integral part of the Pakistan Festival Organizing Committee, to join us on stage and share a few words. Haroon Khan.
Where are you?
Assalamu alaikum. Come on. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome. Welcome to 2016 Pakistan Festival. What an amazing day. What an amazing turnout. Look at this. Here we are in the Poole Plaza. In 2010, we had the Winter Olympics that we hosted. Right now in Rio in 2016, the Olympic fever, the spirit is here. And we feel that here. And we feel the spirit of supernatural BC and the spirit of our country, Pakistan. You know, I was actually born in a small town called Fort St. John, BC. I'm as Canadian as you can get. But here I am representing the Pakistan-Canada Association. This was founded in 1963, well over 50 years ago, by my father, the late Riyasat Ali Khan, and many pioneers of our community who are sitting here with us today. And without them, we would not be here today. So I want to thank all the pioneers who've really made our community what it is. You should be proud that our flag is rising in our city. So thank you. This year marks the fifth annual. From now on, this will be annual Pakistan Festival. And today, each and every one of you will get a chance to see a journey through Pakistan, through its children. There's an amazing parade behind her. Amazingly, beautifully dressed kids. You've got a fashion show of all the best of fashion of Pakistan. You've got a walk through Pakistan. You've got the food of Pakistan. What you're going to see is the spirit and the love and the compassion and the energy of us unified as Canadians. Because it's our diversity that makes us who we are, that makes this country so special, that makes it our home. And it's as much of a celebration of Canada as it is for Pakistan. I'd like to acknowledge a very special guest here, Senator Salma Atolijan. Thank you so much for being here. You honor and grace us with your presence. All of our dignitaries here, MLAs, MPs, there's so many of you, and I'm sure that everyone's names will be mentioned. But I do want to really take some time to acknowledge and appreciate the volunteers, the many young kids, the women, the children who've made this event possible. And they're working at it, and they'll be working. They worked well early this morning to set this beautiful place up, and they'll be here late into the night to bring it down. So let's have a hand for all of our volunteers. Now, you know, life's an interesting thing. You've got times of great happiness, and then things that happen just out of left field. And my time here today, I'd like to dedicate to my younger brother, Asif Khan, and my nephew, Shahzad Khan, who couldn't be here today. But you know what? I feel them, I feel their presence here, and one thing that they loved is a great time and a great party. And this is what's going to happen here today. So again, welcome, Pakistan Festival 2016. We're on, we're here, right now. Thank you.
I would now like to invite Jenny Wan, words. Thank you.
I'm the MP for Vancouver East. And first, I'd like to acknowledge the First Peoples, the Musqueam, the Squamish, and the Tsleil Waututh people, to which the lands that we stand on in their unceded territory. I'd like to have a special welcome to the dignitaries, all the many different council generals that are here, the United Nations are here at this wonderful festival. Senators, MPs, MLAs, representatives, community leaders, parents, children. I am so happy to be here to celebrate with you the Pakistan Festival and to congratulate, first off, you to your pioneers for the hard work, their fight for independence, and the recognition of your nation. Today is a reflection of who we are as Canadians. We are the faces of the world, and you are a big part of this world and big part of Canadian society. For us to gather together, for us to share our culture, to understand our different practices, to appreciate each other, to respect each other, that speaks to the essence of all of us. And you're an important mosaic of the Canadian fabric. So I want to thank you all so much for being us and being our face in the global society. A big thank you to all the sponsors, to all the volunteers, and the organizing committee for putting this together so that we can unite as one as we go forward in support of each other, so that we can, in each and every one of us, have success in our own communities as part of the broader community. Thank you all so much, and enjoy the festival. Thank you.
Festival Organizing Committee. And today, I have the pleasure to invite Dr. Barbara Rana to join us at the stage and share a few words.
Honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. On August 14, 1947, Pakistan was created after the great sacrifice of 500,000 lives. Pakistan came into being as an independent nation, and all of us, for this is a very special day to celebrate our homeland, and also all the Canadians who live, all the Pakistanis who live in Canada. As we are gathered under the shadow of our flag, we need to look at our history of 1969 years. It is time for us to reflect what we have gained and what we have lost as Pakistanis. As long as it soars in the sky, this flag is a testament to the resilient people of Pakistan. It truly signifies how we love our country. The crescent and the star are a symbol of light and express our desire to progress. The green reflects the majority and the white minority religions and our desire to be accepting and tolerant. As a proud Pakistani, I would say that our community has these qualities of being very accepting and tolerant. We are warm and vibrant people who want to show our heritage to people, but on the other hand, we also want to contribute actively to the social fabric of Canada, and we want to become an active part of it. As many of you know, Pakistani Canadian Women's Society was formed to empower our women from within our community by giving them a platform so they can connect and work together in bringing a positive change in the society. One of the main components of our mandate is to organize multicultural events and to connect with diverse communities. Our organization has been one of the main organization arranging the Pakistan Festival over the last few years. It's not just that we organize the Pakistan Festival, we also do a lot of work to strengthen friendships with other communities and to show them who Pakistanis are. On this occasion, I would also like to express our heartfelt sympathy towards the lives which were lost in Quetta because of the bomb blast. We are celebrating here, but there are a lot of people who are sad in Pakistan because of this event. I would, on behalf of Pakistan, ECWS, I would like to express my wishes and would like to say Happy Pakistan Day to all of you guys. Pakistan, Zindabad.
Many of those passengers, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, were not allowed to land here. But today, because of the hard work of all those pioneers, many of them sitting here, they were mentioned. Hard work that they pour in to make Canada a better place. And today, right here, where our passengers were not allowed to land, we have Canadian flag and Pakistani flag flying side by side. What a journey! And I want to tell you, on behalf of my colleagues that are here, Bruce Walton, MLA from Surrey Wally, Rod Chauhan, MLA from Burnaby Edmonds, and we have Richard Lee from Burnaby as well. I want to say that struggle that our pioneers took isn't over yet. Just yesterday, outside of New York, two people were shot because they were praying their own religion. That struggle will continue because I've never seen a community under such attack and scrutiny around the world as we have seen our Muslim community all over the world today. Especially from those powerful people who, for their own personal interest, the president candidates in the United States are making demagoguery remarks for their own successes at the expense of our very peaceful community. That has to end because that struggle will continue on. And we must band together to face that challenge. Otherwise, individually, we will all fall. And we will never let that happen. And I have a message from BC NDP leader John Horgan, who couldn't be here today because he had earlier arrangements to be out of the province today. So I just want to read his message to all of you and everyone else who couldn't be here today from Pakistan and our community outside. He says here, on behalf of the British Columbia's New Democrat Caucus, I would like to extend my best wishes to all those celebrating Pakistan Independence Day. It was on August 14, 1947, that Pakistan became a fully sovereign nation under the leadership of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, who successfully campaigned for an independent Pakistan and became its first leader. As we acknowledge the sacrifices the Pakistani people have made since the birth of a great nation, we can also take pride in strides Pakistan has made nationally and internationally. We also want to acknowledge and recognize those individuals and organizations that have promoted Pakistani culture and heritage. Today in particular, we take pride in the work of Pakistani Canadian Culture Association of BC, PCA of Canada, in building bridges and creating cultural awareness of BC Pakistani community. The PCA BC its board members and volunteers have worked tirelessly to encourage, promote, and enable Pakistan's or Canadians of Pakistan origin in BC to contribute to the rich diversity of multi-ethnic Canada. With the organizations such as PCA, BC, Pakistan Canada Women's Society, that we can learn, understand, and share each other's values, customs, traditions, and beliefs. Across the country, Canadians of Pakistan descent will be celebrating this day with family and friends and with other communities. It is a time for all of us to acknowledge the valuable relationship the people of Pakistan have with Canada. We hope the community continues the fine work it has become renowned for and goes from strength to strength. On behalf of the BC New Democrat Caucus, we extend our warm wishes for a very happy happy and festive Pakistan Independence Day and a prosperous future to all Pakistani Canadians. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day today, because this is what Canada that was left behind us by those people who came before us. But our resolve is to make this Canada even better than the Canada that we have inherited from our pioneers. Thank you very much. Have fun.
रहीम अस्सलाम वालेकुम मेरे पाकिस्तानी बहन भाइयों, मैं आज इतनी खुश हूँ कि फाइनली 6 साल के बाद मैं वैंकूवर आई हूँ और जो हमारे पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी हैज डन इन कैनेडा एंड इट वाज अ टेस्टमेंट टू द मल्टीकल्चरल फैब्रिक ऑफ दिस ग्रेट कंट्री ऑफ आर्स. We are very fortunate to live in a country which encourages us to celebrate our differences, and we can stand up and very proudly say we are who we are. I am very, very happy to be here in Vancouver. I was here a few months ago. I couldn't say no to Tariq. You have an amazing council general. He reaches out across the nation to everyone. To my community, I am what I am because of you. You are my strength, and I am very happy to represent you. And you know, I need to see more of you in Ottawa. I am alone in the Senate. I need more Pakistanis there. So while we think of other careers, I want you to think of politics as a career too. And to all the young people here, you're our future. And please come and say hello to me and talk to me. And you know, I do work in the Senate. I'm deputy chair of the Human Rights Committee. I do a lot of statements on Pakistan. I am your voice in the Senate of Canada. If there's any issue that you would like me to highlight, please, please get in touch with me. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, everything. I left 4 events in Toronto. I got here last night, and once we're done here, I'm heading back to the airport. But I wanted to show my commitment to my people and to tell you that I love you and thank you for what you are. Love is.